Oh, cool. All right, so Ben must be there. Hi, Benny. Glad we're all here. All right, so here we go. I will do take two. Welcome to yoga this Saturday morning, January 23rd. I hope you have a nice quiet space for the next hour together. We will breathe, and for me personally, I'll be breathing deeper than I have in the last 4 years. And we're gonna hopefully finish our practice feeling revived and ready for the rest of our day. So let's go ahead and start with some relaxation. We're gonna go down onto our backs. Let our arms rest at our sides, palms open to the sky. Let's close our eyes and begin to breathe deeply in through the nose. Expand your belly back and ribcage on the inhale. Exhale out through your nose as well. While we're breathing deeply in through the nose and out through the nose, let's bring awareness to our arms and let's breathe from our shoulders to our fingertips. Let's guide our breath into our legs and we'll breathe from our hips to our toes. And next, let's guide our breath into our spine and let's breathe from the top of our head all the way down to the tailbone. Let your breath weave itself in between each segment of your spine. Now let's bring our breath and our awareness into our face. I want you to relax your eyes, relax your cheeks. Relax your jaw. And then breathe away any tension in your neck. And go ahead and turn your eyes to look to the right. Come back to neutral and we'll turn our eyes to look left. And then come back to that neutral place. I want you to draw your chin towards your chest. And then let that head find neutral. Inhale the arms to the sky and exhale, let's reach behind us. Stretch out through your fingers and push out through your heels. And then feel your body go soft. Stretch again, extend out through your fingers and push out through your heels. And then let your body go soft. Now inhale the arms back up. And exhale, return them to your sides. From there, let's draw the left knee into the chest and give it a nice close hug. Flex and point our foot. And then circle the ankle, lead with your big toe. Let's do a few the other way. And then just hold your foot flexed and try to spread your toes out really wide. Scrunch them super tight. Spread them wide. Scrunch them tight. And then just relax. Let's switch the legs. In goes the right, out goes the left. Same thing, we'll start with a flexed point. And then let's roll the ankle lead with your big toe. And do a few the other way. And then we can just rest our foot. And then I want you to spread your toes out really wide. Scrunch them really tight. Spread them wide. Scrunch tight. Once more, spread wide. and then scrunch tight, and then let your foot relax. Now let's bring both knees in nice and close to the body. Give yourself a hug. Add a few rocks from side to side. Come back to neutral and we'll circle our knees around, massaging through that low back. And then let's reverse our circles. And then we'll hug the knees in nice and tight. Tighten the belly, press through the back of the ribs, and come on up, nose towards knees, chin towards chest. And release down. Try again, tighten the belly, round up, nose to knees, chin to chest. And release. Once more, round up, nose to knees, chin to chest. And release. Now let's set the right foot on the mat and extend your left leg towards the sky and just push out through the heel of your foot and draw the leg a little closer to your body. So begin to feel the stretch in the back of that thigh. Let's bend the knee and place our ankle on our thigh and then use that left hand to push gently on your inner thigh. Breathing into your left hip. Let's ease up and then set that foot down and we'll switch. Right knee comes in, extend towards the sky, press out through the heel. Feel that stretch beginning in that hamstring. And then let's bend the knee, place ankle on thigh, and then use that right hand to push on your inner right thigh. Breathing into your hip. Ease up a bit. Now let's cross that leg all the way over the other and lift your feet from the floor. See if you can grab hold of your ankles and just pull your legs a little closer. Let's release and change the cross. Same thing, bring your knees in, pull a little closer. Now uncross and just give yourself another tight hug. And then just let your ankles cross and we're gonna hook around our big toes. Tighten the belly, press through the back of the ribs, come on up into that C shape. And then as we exhale, we're gonna roll up. And once we're up, we can sit cross-legged. Let your palms open, face to the sky, backs of the hands rest on your knees. Allow your chin to fall to your chest and breathe into the back of your neck. Lift the head to back, open your throat. Try again, chin to chest. Lift the head to back, open the throat. And again, chin to your chest. Now let the left ear drop to the left. Chin down and roll to the right. Chin down and roll left. Chin down and roll right. Chin down and roll left. And hesitate there, placing your left hand just above your tip of your right ear and then pushing your right palm into the earth. Breathing up the arm and along the side of your neck. Now let's extend that right arm towards the sky and just gaze up. It's actually your left arm up. And then let that arm float down. And let's do some shoulder rolls from back to front. Turn them into some bigger arm circles. And then just stretch your arms out, push out through your palms. And let your hands come back down. Drop your chin to your chest. Tipping right ear to right shoulder this time and placing right hand just above the left ear. Push your left palm to the earth. Let's extend towards the sky and just gaze up. Good, let that arm float down. And again, let's shoulder roll from back to front. To make our circles a little larger. And then just stretch your arms out. Again, push out through the heels of your hands. Now let your hands come together at heart center. Take a big inhale while we're here. Exhale, push palms towards the sky. And inhale, come back down. Exhale, push palms to the sky. And inhale, back down. Exhale, palms to the sky. And inhale, back down. Once more, exhale to the sky. And then inhale, back down. Let's lace our fingers, push our palms forward, lean a little bit forward. And then we rise up and open wide. Let's take one more inhale as we are. Exhale, let's soften a bit and transition onto hands and knees. So once we've made it on hands and knees, make sure your hands are directly under your shoulders, fingers widespread, hands rotated in slightly. So if we were to move them closer together, thumb and index fingers would form a triangle. Meanwhile, we've got our hips over our knees and we've got the tops of our feet pressed into the mat. Start to sink your navel as you lift your tailbone, lift your head, open your heart cow. Exhale, round the spine, scoop inward for cat. Inhale for cow. And exhale, cat. Inhale, cow. Exhale, cat. Once more, inhale, cow. And exhale, round for cat. Make your way back to a neutral spine. Now go ahead and extend the right leg behind you. Push out through your heel and add the left arm forward, turning left palm towards the sky. Exhale, lower and switch. Sending the left leg back, the right arm forward, rotating palm to the sky. Exhale, lower. Let's switch again. Extend and reach. Now bring the knee to meet the elbow. Re-extend. Knee to elbow. Re-extend. Once more, knee to elbow. And extend. Come back down and we'll switch. Extending the arm and leg, reach. Pull the knee to meet the elbow. Re-extend. Let's try one more. And then hold right there. Come back to all fours. Separate your knees while your big toes stay touched and push back with your tailbone. Let your head drop, forehead to the mat. Feel your chest come between your knees and just allow your body to sink deeper down. So let's use extended child's pose whenever our bodies need a break. It's also the perfect place to begin our downward facing dog because our hands and feet are in the right position for our body length. Let's tuck our toes and start to lift our tailbone. Pushing towards the sky, let your head drop through your arms. Feel your rib cage pull closer to your thighs. And the back of your shoulder blades drawing towards your gluteals. Nod your head yes. Shake your head no. And then just let it dangle there. Let's go ahead and walk our dog, lifting lower each heel individually. Keep one heel raised and one heel pressed. And then we'll switch. And then drop both of your heels. And then from there, let's inhale forward into a good strong plank. Exhale, press back up into down dog. Inhale forward to plank. And exhale, down dog. Inhale again to plank. Now modify to your knees. As we start lowering, open those elbows, lead with your chest. Then your hips come down. Now your elbows tuck in. And we inhale, lengthen, rise into cobra. Let's press all the way back into extended child's pose. Tuck your toes and we're back up into downward facing dog. Inhale forward to plank. Exhale, modify if you'd like. We're lowering elbows wide, chest down, hips down, elbows come in. Inhale, rise, cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Again, inhale, forward to plank. Exhale, coming down. Inhale, rising up. Exhale, downward facing dog. From here, let's take a giant step forward with our left foot. Placing your foot between your hands, eyes looking out. We've got knee over ankle. Our back leg is strong and straight. You're pushing out through that heel. Now go ahead and drop the right knee down. Press through the top of our right foot. And then let's rise up into crescent moon. Exhale, fold forward, hands to the mat. Tuck the right toes under, return to your lunge. Send the left foot back, hold on to plank. Press back up into down dog. Now this time we'll step right, left foot forward, or right foot forward, sorry. Knee over ankle, eyes looking out. Push out through the heel of that straight leg. And then go ahead and sink down. Pressing through the top of that foot, let's reach to the sky. Crescent moon. Exhale, fold forward. Tucking left toes under. We're back into our lunge. And then from there, let's step our foot forward and come into forward bend. So while we're here, think about bringing your big toes closer together, keeping your heels apart, and just letting your body dangle down. And then let's inhale and slowly rise. Reach high, touch the sky. Exhale into your heart. Inhale again to the sky. And exhale to our heart. Inhale, touch the sky. And exhale to the heart. This time, let's inhale to the sky and exhale, fold forward. Inhale, look out. And exhale, sink deeper. Right foot steps back, left foot steps back into plank. Exhale as we lower. Inhale, lengthen, rise into cobra. Exhale, tuck your toes, downward facing dog. Inhale, forward to plank. And exhale again, down dog. Right foot forward, left foot forward, toes and heels out. Inhale, let's roll up. Reach high, touch the sky. And exhale to your heart. Again, inhale to the sky. And exhale, fold forward. Inhale, look out. And exhale as we sink. Left foot back, right foot back, plank. Exhale, coming down. Inhale, rising up. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale to plank. And exhale, down dog. Left foot forward, right foot forward, toes in, heels out. Inhale, rolling up. Reach high, touch the sky. Exhale to the heart. Inhale again, extend. And exhale, fold forward. Inhale, look out. Exhale as we sink. Right foot back, plank. Exhale, coming down. Inhale, rising up. Exhale, down dog. Inhale again to plank. And exhale, down dog. Right foot forward, left foot forward, toes and heels out. Inhale, roll up. Reach, touch the sky. Exhale to the heart. Again, inhale, extend. And exhale, fold forward. Inhale, look out, and exhale as we sink. Left foot back, plank. Exhale, coming down. Inhale, rising up. Exhale, down dog. Inhale, forward. And exhale, down dog. Left foot forward, toes and heels out. Inhale, rise, look out. Exhale, sink deeper. Inhale, roll up, reach high, touch the sky. Exhale to your heart. Inhale again. And exhale, fold. Inhale, look out. Exhale, sink deeper. Right foot steps back. And let's hang out in our lunge. Now we're ready to push our right heel down. Turn our right toes out. Align your right heel with the back of your left heel and start lifting. We've got our hips forward, our shoulders stacked. When ready, add your arms, creating Warrior One. Feel your body weight centered equally between your feet. Good, and let your arms open, open your heart. And then just come back to a more neutral spine. Begin to hinge forward, bringing us into a warrior airplane. Let the arms come forward again, framing your ears. And then we inhale and rise back up into Warrior One. From there, let's pull the front leg straight. Reopen the arms and rotate. So now we're going to face the wide edge of our mat and adjust your feet so your toes are in, your heels are out. Be a little wider than your hips, arms outstretched. Here's our five-pointed star. Now let's hinge forward, stopping once our back is parallel to the sky. And then as we exhale, let your hands return to the mat. From there, let's inhale, look out, and exhale, sink down. Let your forearms come closer to the mat. Let your head drop. And just breathe. Let's push down into our palms, pushing the arms straight, and then try lifting your heels so you're on the big toe knuckles. Press the heels back down. Let's bend our knees. Back up. Again, let's raise our heels. Press the heels down and bend our knees. And then push legs straight. And now I want you to take that left hand, move it so it's centered beneath you, and push on it with your right hand. Inhale your right arm to the side, exhale, revolve the waist, and there's our twisting straddle. Exhale that hand down. Again, inhale, let's look out with our flat back, and then as we exhale, arms go wide, and then we'll inhale and rise all the way up. Palms again to the sky, we're back into our five-pointed star. From there, let's inhale the arms higher to the sky. Now let your fingertips meet together, and then let your palms meet together. Place all of your fingers, feel your shoulders dropping from your ears, and then push your palms to the sky. While you're pushing through the palms, you can bring them forward. Feel that deep stretch across the upper back and the back of your shoulders. And then let's come back out into our star. Now we're ready to turn our left toes to face the front end of our mat. Align your left heel with your right arch. Stay looking out over that left hand and then bend the left knee. Bring it out over your ankle, and that brings us into Warrior Two. Feel your body weight center equally into both feet. Get the weight in our front foot. I want you to feel that little area underneath your second, third, and fourth toes. Let's extend a little forward. Now lift that arm, lower the opposite, turning left palm to the sky, reverse warrior. And then from there, let's bring the left forearm to the left thigh and the right arm high. Here's extended angle pose. The right arm's gonna lower towards the right hip so it makes a full circle. On the way back up, we're back into Warrior Two. And let's pull the legs straighter and straighter without locking, so we're back where we started. And now we can begin to pull that right hip behind us as we extend our left arm farther and farther out, Once we can't go any further, let's lower the left and lift the right. And there's our triangle pose. So it's as though we're being pressed open against a wall. Not feeling any tension in that right shoulder. We're actually pressing the right hip a little bit forward so the body stays aligned and open. Take one more inhale. On the exhale, let's start to bend the left knee. And we can revolve the upper body. Let your hands return to the mat. And we're back into our runner's lunge. Now let's step the left foot back. Hang on to your plank. Modify if you'd like. Exhale, we're going down. Inhale, we're rising up. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, forward to plank. And exhale again, down dog. Take a step forward with your right foot, return to your lunge. Once there, let's keep our left hand pressed down and then inhale, right arm to the side, exhale, revolve. There's our twisting lunge. Exhale that right hand down. Begin to push your right leg straight and let's extend the left leg behind us hip level, and there's our tripod balance. We've got both hands forming a tripod with our right foot. We can remain like that or align our right thumb with our right pinky toe. Start to open the left hip and then add that left arm to the sky. And there's our half moon balance. Exhale the hand down if it's lifted. And then go ahead and step that left foot in. And then from there, I want you to bend your knees. And as you're bending your knees, pull them closer together. Begin to lift your ribs away from your thighs. Add your arms alongside your ears. And there's our chair pose. We'll inhale, reach high, touch the sky. Exhale to the heart. Inhale again to the sky. And then exhale, fold forward. Let's inhale, look out. And exhale, sink deeper. Let's take a moment to cradle our elbows in the palms of our hands. Form a loose frame around your head and just let your body let go. Hands release to the mat. And now we're ready to take a giant step back with our left foot into lunge. Once there, push your left heel down, turn your left toes out. Align your right heel with the back of your left heel, and when ready, start to lift upper body. Keeping our hip bones facing forward, add your arms to the sky, warrior one. Let's open the arms and open the heart. And we'll bring our spine back to neutral and begin to hinge forward, leading with your ribs. There's our warrior airplane. And let your arms frame your ears. We'll inhale, rise back up into warrior one. Start to pull the right leg straight. Let the arms go wide and then let's rotate. And now we're facing the wide edge of our mat. So we've got our toes and our heels out. Five pointed star. Belly button tight as we hinge forward brings us into our straddle airplane. And then let's hinge forward. Let your hands meet the mat. Inhale while we're here looking out. And then exhale as we mount. Forearms drop. Breathe. Go ahead and push down into your palms once again. And then begin to shift your weight to your left. Pull that right inner thigh towards the mat. Come back up and we'll shift. Again, come up and we'll shift. And come back up and shift again. And then bring yourself back to that neutral place. Now we're ready to slide the right hand over so it's centered beneath us and push on it with your left. Inhale, left arm to the side. Exhale, revolve at the waist. Twisting straddle. Once there, inhale into our flat back. Exhale, arms open. We're back in our straddle airplane. And then from there, we inhale and rise to standing. Toes in, heels out. Palms to the sky. Live pointed star. Now let's rotate palms to face forward. And they're going to meet in front of us. Lace all of your fingers and then press your index fingers together. Tika, yeah. Inhale, arms to the sky. Let your upper arms frame your ears. While we're here, we'll do a little side stretch to one side. Come back up and side stretch to the other side. Back up, once again, side stretch. Lift up and stretch. Lift again. And then let's open the arms on our exhale so we're back in our star. Now we're ready to turn our right toes to the front end of our mat. Align our right heel with our left arch. Keeping the body open and straight, let's bend the right knee. Finding that place where our body weight is centered equally into both feet. The weight that's in that forward foot, though, I want you to feel that ball of the foot area right under your second, third, and fourth toes. Let's extend the arm a little further forward. Now lift it up. Lower the left and turn your right palm to the sky. Reverse warrior. And then from there, let's move into extended angle pose. And then take that left arm, it makes a full circle around. As we come up, we're back into warrior two. Now we're ready to draw that leg straighter and straighter. We're back to where we started. Ready to move into our triangle pose. Let's start pulling our left hip left and reaching that right arm out as far as it can go. Once we can't go any further, we can lower the right and lift the left. And that brings us into our triangle pose. So never feel like you're done with the pose. Always try to work it opening a little bit more, keeping the arms powerful and strong, but relaxing the shoulders and the neck. Breathing into that space you've created in your spine. Take one more inhale as we are. On the exhale, let's start to bend that right knee, revolve the upper body. Once your hands make it to the mat, we're back into lunge. Then we're gonna press that left hand into the mat, inhale the right arm to the side, exhale, revolve at our waist, and there's our twisting lunge. Mm-hmm. Exhale that hand down. Let's step back. Hold your plank. Exhale on the way down. Inhale, rise on the way up. Exhale, back up into down dog. Inhale, forward to plank. And exhale again, down dog. And then step the left foot forward. Return to your lunge. Let's keep the right hand pressed down this time. Inhale the left, revolve at the waist. Twisting lunge on the other side. Exhale that hand down. Press your weight forward into your front foot and then extend the right leg behind you and push out through that heel. So therein is our tripod balance and we're gonna stay like that or we can move into our half moon by simply aligning our left thumb with our left pinky toe, opening the right hip, extending the right arm. Exhale that hand down if it's lifted. And then go ahead and step the right foot in. Let our big toes close our heels apart. And then we start to bend the knees. And while we're bending the knees and sinking our hips, I want you to pull your knees closer together. Lift your ribs from your thighs. Add your arms alongside your ears. And there's our chair pose. And then as we inhale, we can rise out of our chair. Exhale, let your hands come to your heart. And then just find yourself in your mountain pose. All right, so for mountain pose, let's move into a little bit of balance work. Find that focal point for your eyes. Begin to shift your weight into your right foot. Again, think about pressing into the second, third, and fourth ball of your foot area. Now try bending your left knee so your heel comes towards your bottom and then place the inside of your left foot in the palm of your hand and then bring the right arm forward. And then if you want to, you can expand and open your dancer. And then let's release from there. Bring ourselves back into our standing mountain pose. And then we're ready to shift our weight now into our left foot. So same thing, got our focal point, our belly button's tight. Pressing into the ball of our foot area, let's bend the right knee. Let the inside of your right foot rest in the palm of your hand. Bring that left arm forward. And then if you want to, you can expand and open. And then let's release. And return to mountain pose. Open your heart, open your throat. Inhale, touch the sky. And exhale, fold forward. Inhale, look out. And exhale, sink deeper. Again, we're going to cradle our elbows in the palms of our hands. Let your upper body rest against your thighs. And then let's release our hands to the mat. Step back with your right foot and your left foot, holding onto plank. Now let's keep that left shoulder over left wrist and we'll turn it over to the side plank. You know the modification. Side of the knee on the mat. Exhale, come back around into your plank. Press up into down dog. Return to plank. Lift the right foot, not hop too high. Press back into three-legged dog. Come forward, and now bring the right knee forward so it comes right up to your right elbow. And we're gonna set the top of our right foot, our shin and our knee on the mat. Aim your right heel at your left hip bone and then start to slide the left leg further back. Sink the left knee down and then start to melt down into your pigeon pose. So while we're in pigeon pose, I want you to really press the outer edge of your right pinky toe into the mat and press the top of your left foot into the mat. One more inhale as we are. And then as we exhale, we can start to lift back up. That's going to bring us into our third position pigeon. And then see about tucking the toes under on that left foot, lifting your left knee. Send the right foot back. That brings us back into plank. And now we're ready for the other side. So we've got right shoulder over right wrist, turning into side plank. Modify to the side of your knee if you'd like. And then come back around into your plank. Press up into down dog. Inhale again to plank. Lift the left foot not too high. Press up into three-legged dog. And then from there, we're gonna pull the left knee forward so it comes up towards the left elbow. Set the top of your left foot, your shin, and your knee on the mat. Aim your left heel at your right hip bone. Sink the right knee and then start to stretch that leg a little further back and ease down. And we're working at pressing our weight into that right pinky toe or left pinky toe. And pressing down to the top of our right foot as we melt a little deeper. And from there, let's start to inhale and lift, bringing us into our third position pigeon. And then go ahead and tuck your right toes under to lift your right knee. Send your left foot back, bringing us into our plank. Let's press back up into down dog. Again, we'll nod our head yes, shake our head no, and then just let it hang there. And then from here, I want you to take your right hand, move it slightly center. Take your left hand so you can grab hold of your right ankle. Let's bring that out and we'll switch. So now we'll keep our left hand down. It's about centered. And the right hand can come across and grab hold of the outside left. And then bring that hand back out. And once again, downward facing dog. Now we're ready to come down onto all fours. Separate your knees, let your big toes meet. Push back with your tailbone. Extend your arms, let your forehead drop through your arms. Feel your chest pulling towards the mat. Now let's ease forward onto our forearms. Walk your feet back, and there's forearm plank. And then we can ease to the knees, let the tops of our feet rest, and then melt yourself down. Let your forehead rest on the back of your hands. And then from there, let's extend the left arm out straight. I want you to roll onto your side. Bend the right knee so your heel comes close to your bottom. Then grab hold of your ankle, your foot, your pant leg, whatever you might be able to reach, pulling your heel closer to your bottom. Feeling that stretch in the front of your thigh. And while you're still attached, let's roll onto the belly. And then try to extend that forward arm a little bit more as you lift up. Let's lift your thigh as well. Exhale as we sink. Go ahead and stretch out everything nice and straight. And then we'll roll onto our right side and try the same thing. So let's bend the left knee, bring your heel close to your bottom, grab hold of whatever you might be able to reach. And then while we're still attached, you can roll onto your belly. Try extending that arm a little longer, then lift the arm as you lift your thigh. And let's release. Stretch everything out nice and long and straight. And then from here, we're going to bend both knees, bring them in towards your body. Let your arms come down alongside you. So we're going to grab hold of our ankles, our pant leg, our feet, whatever we can reach. If we can't reach anything, that's okay. You can keep your arms at your sides and your fingers reaching down your outer thighs. But we're all going to tighten the belly, and then I want you to start to lift your heart. Try to lift your thighs. And then as we exhale, we can sink back down, release. Turn your head to one side. Let your body melt into the mat. Let's bring the right arm forward. Now we're going to pass the left arm through the right armpit. Let your shoulders sink onto the mat. And then see if you can pass the right arm in front of the left. And there's our knot. And we can just release into it. So this one's for Stephanie and Betty. Let's keep the right arm where it is, but unthread the left. Stretch it out straight, and again, we'll just sink down. And then see if you can pass the left arm across in front. We're back in our knot. And then from there, we'll re-extend both arms out and sink down. Slide the hands closer to the shoulders, tuck your elbows in, press through the tops of your feet and your hip bones, lengthen as you rise, and then try pressing all the way back and return to extended child's pose. Then we're just gonna let the arms come alongside us, palms face the sky, roll your shoulders towards the mat. Release hands under shoulders, we'll press up. And then just bring yourself around, we'll have a seat. So let's start out with our butterfly. We'll bring the soles of our feet close together. Let your feet rest in your palms, and then pull your heels in a little closer to your body. While we're doing that, think about opening your knees wider. Exhale, let's soften a bit. And then from there, we'll stretch the left leg out straight and bring the right knee upright. Let's walk that right foot in as close as we can, keeping our sit bones on the mat. And start out by wrapping the left arm around the bent right knee. Inhale, sitting taller and straighter. Exhale, looking over that shoulder. And then as we exhale, let's untwist and simply extend the arms so they're alongside that straight leg. So you can get a little bit more length. And then try wrapping that right arm around the bent left, the right knee. Come around with the left hand. See if you can hook your hands together or get them really, really close. And then sit up taller and straighter and look over your shoulder. And then as we exhale, let's untwist and we'll switch legs. So now we'll keep the right leg extended. We'll bend the left knee, walking our foot in closer. Nice and tall and straight, sit bones on the mat. We wrap the right arm around the bent left knee. Inhale a little bit taller and exhale to turn and look over your shoulder. Exhale, we can untwist. Let your hands reach down alongside that straight leg so you can get a little bit more length. And then try wrapping the left arm around the bent left knee. Sit a little taller as you try to get your hands to meet or come close together. And then once you've got your position, we're going to look over that shoulder. Let's exhale, come back around. And now we'll stretch both legs out straight. You can keep a little bit of a bend as you hinge forward and try to hook around your toes. And then once there, see about pulling yourself a little deeper down as you push your legs straighter. And then let's inhale our way back up. And then once we're up, we can bend our knees. Let's place our hands behind our thighs. Hold the belly button tight, keeping the spine as straight as you can, and simply find your balance on your tailbone. Now try extending your legs, go where you can without rounding your back. And then see if you can edge your arms. And then we're gonna slowly open from there, one segment at a time. Pressing us all the way into the mat. So then once we're down, flex your feet, push out through your heels, reach out through your fingers. Feel your body go a little soft. And then pull the right knee to your chest and give it a hug. Let's circle that knee around. And then just keep it hugged in. And switch legs. Other knee pulls in. Starting with the hug. Adding an easy circle around. And then back to the hug. And then let's bring both knees in. And then we'll set our feet down. Keep them spaced apart about hips distance. Toes and heels out, arms at our sides. Enough space between your heels and your buttocks so that when we lift up into bridge, we're really working the back side of our body. So one vertebra at a time. Gonna press up into that bridge. And then let's inch our way back down one segment at a time. And then once we've made it all the way down, bring knees to chest, circle both knees around. And then let's reverse. And then let's extend the legs towards the sky. Arms at our sides. There is our most modified version of shoulder stand. want to venture into full shoulder stand. Want to make sure we're using the belly to pull us up and hold us there. Your hands are just kind of helping, but they shouldn't be doing all the work. Make sure you're not feeling any weight in your neck. And then if you're in full shoulder stand, pull your knees to your ears. If you're in modified shoulder stand, just knees to chest. Full shoulder stand people, we're gonna roll down so we end up with our knees and our chest. And then we can all set our feet back down on the mat. Position them again to draw yourself up into your bridge one segment at a time. And then let's melt it all the way back down. Once we're all the way back down, we can bring the knees back in. Always feels good to stretch and rock gently side to side. And then come back to neutral and spread those arms out nice and wide. Holding the belly button nice and tight, let's drop our knees all the way to the left as you look right. Use the belly to pull you back up. And then we're gonna let them drop all the way to the right as we look left. And then let's pull back up. And from there, we can rest our feet back down. Bring the arms closer to the body, palms still open to the sky, and then one leg at a time, we're just gonna stretch it out straight. Once they're fully extended, flex your feet and push out through your heels, so tense the muscles in those legs. Then do the same with the arms, stretch your arms really straight from your shoulders to your fingertips. And then while you're doing that, pull your belly button super tight. So everything's working here, but we're still breathing normally. And then try relaxing your legs first. Relaxing your arms. And then relax your belly. And just feel your body melting into the mat. Breathe in through the nose, out through the nose. And let's guide our breath around the body. So first thing I want you to do is pick your favorite color and attach that color to your breath. And see it going into the body. Swirl around your forehead, long and behind the eyes. Around the jaw. We're seeing all that color moving into the neck and the shoulders, and it gets more intense as it enters those areas. Going to move down the arms and out through our fingertips. You can see it move back up into the shoulders and start to move down the spine. But it really weaves itself in between each segment, and as it does, we can see the space it's creating by that color in between each vertebra. See to yet intensify into your pelvis. Moving down through the legs. Swirling the knees. Swirling the ankles. Moving in between each and every toe. Makes its way all the way back up through the hips. Let it hang out in your belly. When day comes, we step out of the shade, aflame and unafraid. The new dawn blooms as we free it, for there is always light. If only we're brave enough to see it, if only we're brave enough to be it. Let us set aside all of our anxious thoughts. Make a choice to live today with courage, with an open heart and a grateful heart and a hopeful heart. Know that my soul honors your soul. I honor the place in you where the entire universe resides. I honor that light, love, truth, beauty, and peace within you because it's also within me. In sharing these things, we are united. We are the same. We are one. Namaste. So let's go out, enjoy the day, spread those random acts of kindness, go play in the snow. Don't forget when you're around people, we're going to wear our masks covering our nose and our mouth, and make sure that we wash our hands diligently 20 seconds at a time, and that we maintain our social distance. Have a great day. Thank you so much for joining me. I will be back tomorrow night to let you know what's happening on Monday morning. Take care. Bye-bye.